There's like whores here and stuff.
Sweetheart, how many times have I told you? Don't say and stuff. Just say, Dad, there are whores here.
No, I like weird shit.
You got your left turns because you're a guy.
I'm somewhere between you and Verzi.
Yes.
I like everything that everybody likes, and then I like weird shit.
Yeah, you'll pull out a show that I've never heard of and be like, you got to watch this fucking show. What was that show you kept telling me to watch, but I didn't have the channel to see it? Midnight in fucking Vegas or whatever, the Sunset Strip police team or whatever the fuck it was called.
What? I don't even remember that.
That fucking 70s cop show you kept telling me to watch. It was called like Sunset Strip at Night.
Oh, 77 Sunset Strip.
77 Sunset Strip. 77 Sunset Strip. 77 Sunset Strip.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. And then I started watching. You got to watch Peter Gunn. Because yeah. Peter Gunn's only a half hour long. And I tell you, that fucking show, man, nobody gets killed quicker on that fucking. Than the first fucking guy, the murder they have to. Every fucking week was a murder.
Did you see?
And there would literally be a guy going out to get the newspaper, and they just show a guy, like a guy would throw the newspaper, and then a guy comes walking out to pick up the newspaper, and then pew, pew, he gets shot, and then it goes, na 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 na, every fucking episode.
That's awesome.
Where?
Did you see The Nice Guys with Gosling and...
That is such an underrated fucking movie. I could not believe how funny, because all I'd seen them do is drama. Yeah. How fucking hilarious they are.
That movie is unbelievable. The
high-pitched yell he does when he does the spiral fracture.
Give me your left arm.
Huh?
Your left arm. Give me your left arm. This one.
No!
Yeah, come on.
No! No!
Did you cut yourself?
I'm dealing with an injury.
Right, look, when you're talking to your doctor, just tell him you have a spiral fracture of the left radius.
No! No!
Deep breath.
No!
He does that. He goes, ah!
That Gosling doing the fucking Abbott and Costello thing with the dead body where he's going, and he's trying to scream,
oh, yeah.
And he's so scared he can't get out any noise. But my favorite thing, I've been waiting to talk to you about this, is the
and it's not on Netflix. It's like the only fucking thing that isn't on Netflix.
The end of the movie, Crow's delivery. It's one of the best comedic deliveries I've ever seen. Like the choice he makes when he's drinking again at the end, and Gosling goes, at least you started drinking again, and he goes, yeah.
You ever see the bad breath, Ty? Breathe on it. It works every time. Kills Holly. At least you're drinking again.
Yeah. Feel great.
I'm like, that's the choice of a man that knows. That's a guy that understands why that's funny. Like,
no, but that's what it was. Because you don't catch either one of them in that whole movie trying to be funny.
Right.
Maybe that one you just brought up was, you know, a little. But that's also a nod back to
the
Abbott and Costello thing. But both of them, everything is delivered totally like they believe everything they're saying.
It's the most sincere delivery, but to me, that's a guy that knows, like, if I do, there are these five shades of sincerity. If I pick that one, that's the one nobody's expected me to.
Yeah.
There's like, yeah, man. You know, like, there's a million yes that pop in your head. He picks the one.
Like, do it again. How did he do it?
He's like, he goes, at least you start drinking again. And he goes, yeah. He's saying it like it's like. Like somebody's being like, well, at least, you know, at least your dad's still around.
Yeah, at least.
Yeah, man. Yeah. I just never would have thought.
You're like
that
the only fucking years. Guy that I've been telling everybody to watch that fucking movie. And then they're like, where is it? And I was like, I don't know.
That scene with that kid. I saw that with Byrne, with Steve Byrne in the theater. We were laughing so fucking hard, dude. That scene with the kid where he's like, I asked him for $20. I told him I'd show him. Asked him if he wanted to see my dick.
Tried to get a job. I offered to show my dick because I got a big dick.
All right.
Yeah.
Oh, that's very nice.
Yeah.
You sure you didn't see another girl?
Nope. You guys want to see my dick?
Nobody wants to see your dick, dude.
$20?
We already paid you 20. What am I saying?
Oh, all right. Bags!
That 12-year-old, I got a real big dick. You want to see it? No. Nobody wants to see your dick.
I forgot all the lines in it because I only saw it once.
It's worth a rewatch.
Where? Where can I see it?
I rewatched it on an airplane.
Come on in here. I found something hidden in the cabinet.
Really? Watch him.
Oh, no. Hey, don't. Oh, don't open that because that's not mine. It belongs to a friend. I just said I'd look after it for him, but it's one of those bags. If you try to open it.
Oh, what?
Shit.
What? Motherfucker! I can't see you! Yeah. Oh, God! What the fuck?
You know that color doesn't come off, right?
Reservations only. No need to wait for seeding. Natives continue bleeding. The circle just keeps repeating. This feeling filling the void. Explore the people changing. It's why I turn the tables like time. Turning the page and going against the grain. Engaged in hell throughout the day. Yeah. No way it's simple or plain. Need to maintain through these pains. Taking these short ends. Making on cause and acrylic abortion. It all costs so all the real can gain applause. Reserves relentless. Yo, it's what I gotta contend with. Sundance the rest demented. Genuine arsenal lessons from beneath the ground sentence. To bless the four elements.